What's going on, guys? JC here, and today we have a very chill game because I am tired of playing these stressful ranked games. So this is a high bronze and low silver game, so for the majority of people out there, like that's like 70 or 80% of the player base would be in this elo. So what are we versing, like a Thresh or Blitzcrank? I don't know, it's pretty troll, but if this was Diamond Elo, if this was Master or Challenger, I'd be pretty scared of a Thresh top, to be honest, because that's literally an ADC, but except mixed with a hard crowd control. Like, it's pretty cancerous, actually, because Thresh in teamfights completely shuts down a Tryndamere. So for a Thresh to be top, that's actually, there's a lot of playmaking potential for him against me. So I'm gonna have to be a lot more careful when I'm facing this guy. But that's only for early game, and we'll see how he plays. If he's playing really badly, then it doesn't even matter. But if he plays well, like, he could easily outplay me because he's Thresh. So he's going for the CS, not the Harass. That's good. We got some Fury. We have to be careful not to get... Oh, wow. He actually timed that perfectly. I was about to kill that minion with the spin and just go on him, but then he flayed me on the exact same second, so that was actually really unlucky. So we're going to go in next on the level 2. That's the plan anyway. So the next minion that dies, I'm just going to spin on him. I'm going to see all these minions are now hitting him because he's getting aggro. What the? I hit a minion. Okay, that works. I think he should have just backed away after he flayed me. He could have easily just walked away. So that, I guess that's like a bronze elo mistake, and that's fine because you expect it. Like, if he was a good Thresh player, like, he actually flayed me perfectly on the first play, so that was actually pretty impressive, and that's what Thresh can do. Like, if he flays you mid-E, your E damage gets cancelled, and you literally get, it goes on cooldown, and you're screwed. Like, literally, that's what happens in a team fight every single time. He could flay you, he could hook you, he could, like, even his ult will just simply slow you without even any effort from him. And that slow is brutal as well. That slow is like a 90% slow or something insane like that. At least it feels that way. It might not be the exact number, like 90%. But you know what I mean, guys. Like, it's pretty brutal. He actually started calling. I just realized that. Calling and one potion. So he's going for the late game. But that doesn't even matter because we're going to try to feed off of him and then just dominate. You guys can do exactly what I do here in your bronze and silver games, because this is literally, there's like a mix of silver and bronze players in this game. I'm not going to bother showing the op.gg. I'll probably show the runes and masteries at the start because I don't want to, you know, it will make them look bad. I don't know. There's no point in showing it. That's what I feel. Maybe for the diamond, master and, you know, challenger games, I'll show it. This is hard pushing to me, so it's really stupid for me to attack him. Like, I might be able to kill him, I don't know, but there's no point because that's a really bad play if I was to go on him aggressively, regardless of what elo this is. And so we'll just farm up, and then the next slow push, we can probably kill him again. Depends on how hard he pokes us, actually. Oh my god, I'm not getting any of the CS, that's really unlucky. He's actually poking us decently hard, so we're going to have to pop a potion. That's gone. We should be able to heal most of it back up. Off of this cannon CS? Yeah, okay, never mind. I was gonna go on him. I'll go on him after this cannon, because this will push decently hard. I also get the level up. Okay. Easy. There we go. He flashes, I flash. There's no other way for him to get away, other than to just flay me away. Like, he literally, the only way for him to disengage is to flay me away when I E to him. And he did that the first time, and that was, like, perfect. Does this Zac want to die? Like, you just move this way because you know he's going to... Oh no, he was just out of my spin range, but I'm gonna ping that the Zac and the Thresh flashed. So yeah, my team's cheering me on, they're all happy, like, yeah, go Trin, go, you know. There was never a doubt that this wasn't gonna happen, so. And you guys could make this happen too, like, for those that say, I'm stuck in elo hell, I need help, like, it's all my teammates. To be honest, it's both teams. Both teams are playing really badly, they both make so many mistakes. And it only takes one player to carry this because of how many mistakes they make that you could just carry it as one person. Like, you can't blame your teammates when you're bronze or silver because it's too easy to carry. Like, I mean, from my point of view, it's too easy to carry. And if you watch my videos, then you can do the same thing. And I'm not really even focusing. I'm actually commentating a lot more than I normally would in a diamond game because this is just second nature, you know. he pushes up, he doesn't anticipate that I can go on him with full fury and a level up, and he just dies like that. And this can happen all the way to like gold, high gold elo. You could abuse the fact that they don't know anything about level up advantage in high elo, in gold. But yeah. But I am missing a lot of CS this game, so please ignore that part. You guys can definitely do better than me at the CS department for sure. Like, it's a mix of bad CSing and bad luck, I'm going to say, with the minion health values. I'm thinking of warding in the tri-bush because that's where we can see the Zac E over the wall. There's no point in putting it here because the Zac would just E from the tri-bush. Like, at this level, like, earlier on, you want to ward from the river because Zac's E actually scales with leveling. Like, the distance it E's scales with the leveling. So, the later on in the game, the further you have to ward. That's the key for Zac ganks. Like, this applies to every elo. So, you might as well just apply it in your bronze games as well.
Bye, have a great time!
Oh my god. Those minions just like aggro to the back line of my minions, so it just went really far away. Not expect that. But we're still at 52 CS, which is... Actually, there's a misfortune on the enemy team with 59. Like, she could be a smurf for all I know. Like, she's doing pretty well on CS. This is kind of risky if I was to, say, go on this Thresh. If this Thresh was any good, if I auto attack and spin away, he could flay me back into the tower and I'll have tower aggro and I'll literally die or I'll have to ult. And then he can just walk me down the lane and kill me. So, against Thresh, you do not want to auto attack and spin away when he's under tower, because he only has to press one button to screw you over completely. So that's why Thresh is so strong against Tryndamere. Like, it's actually a viable pick at top lane against Tryndamere, believe it or not. I'm just gonna hide behind the minion and... Okay. Is he gonna hook me? No. I guess not. I'm gonna thin out the minion wave and look to kill him. But I do have to watch out for the Zac, actually. I have to see where the Zac is because I'm not strong enough to 2v1 just yet. Okay, I'm gonna put another ward a bit further up and I'm going to start to push this back to him and get a kill. I think we're stronger than him though. Like, if he all out fights us right now, I'm stronger. So he literally backed off, meaning we could just freeze this wave here and just get strong and he'll just fall behind. So this is something you can do, like silver bronze players, they'll just leave the lane like slow pushing towards us, which never happens in high elo, by the way. They want to break the freeze by killing these minions and walking us to the tower. But for a bronze, silver, even gold, maybe even low plat, they'll just leave the wave like this and let you freeze. So now the Thresh is getting zero experience, zero gold, and you're getting full experience and full gold. It's as if he's AFK. That's how bad it is to leave the lane slow pushing like this. The worst thing you can do is to push it straight back to his tower, because that means he can just go and claim all that gold and all that experience. And, you know, this, all these minions dying to his minions is the same as him losing the minions to a tower. So that's something that to note if you're, you know, playing in low elo, actually in all elos. So yeah, we just tank it a little bit, go back into bush, de-aggro it, and just keep going with it. Oh my god, my dog is scratching at the door. But I'm not in a position to let him in just yet. I think he'll go away. For those that don't know, I have a King Charles Cavalier. He's a really cute dog. It snores very loud. It likes to snore whenever it sleeps. So I might put a picture up just so you guys have a reference of what he looks like. Wait, did the Thresh roam yet? Or is he just jungling? Or did he AFK? Like, I have this effect on bronze players. They literally just want to AFK after they face me in lane and die a few times. And you can literally do this, like, bronze players are really good at rage quitting, so you might get unlucky and they might rage quit on your team, but if you play well, the chances of them rage quitting on the other team is a lot higher, like significantly higher. So once I get static shiv, I think I have enough gold for static shiv, but I'm just kind of greedy. I just want to freeze this just a bit longer, so I might cut like a little bit of this out, but you guys can get the idea of how to permanently freeze a lane. Like, this is how you permanently freeze. See, look, he's level 7, I'm level 9. I can literally just... He flayed, so I can just walk up to him and kill him. Okay, never mind. Like, he's a Thresh, so that's how you can disengage as Thresh, like, really easily. So this is what I mean by him walking me down into the tower. So that's what you're supposed to do. So he's supposed to have done that, like, a while ago. I value this CS more than his life, but now I can take his life as well. He's dead. I don't even need to bother.
You asshole.
That's a killing spree. Well, so I'm on a killing spree and the score is 5-5. So we actually need to carry this game, guys. Like, our team's actually inting and feeding, which is very normal in a bronze game. It could go either way, but unfortunately for us, it's going against us. So, but that's completely fine. Like you guys are in for a treat because you guys will see how I can just, like, face a bronze player. Like, any bronze player will actually be this easy to kill, believe it or not. Like, you guys try it as well. You guys can literally hop into a bronze silver game and do exactly what I'm doing, and you'll get kills, you'll get fed, and you'll be able to carry, like, 1 versus 9. Well, not 1 versus 9, 1 versus 5. If it's 9, that means our team AFKs or feeds and AFKs, which is probably not doable. We'll probably lose in that case. I'll just go my standard build. The pickaxe will build into Eye Edge, and I probably get a PD because that's my comfort build. If you guys want, I know that most Tryndamere's will build Static Shiv, Vamp Scepter, and then they'll build a Black Cleaver. And that will be the standard build, like, that most Tryndamere's go for. I just like PD, I just like the crits, and the crits give me more mobility, gives me more attack speed, it just feels good. Just my personal preference. You guys don't have to copy it. Especially in, like, low elo game, it doesn't really matter. Like, I literally walk up to him, he just flashed, so I might as well just keep farming, and then I'll dive him later. Like, I could easily flash after him, but it's kind of iffy. Like, I don't have a slow anymore, so he could actually just walk away from me. So, there's no point in flashing after him and being greedy. You just have to assess the situation. If you can flash and get the kill right away, then by all means. I think I'm actually fed enough to do this. Yeah, I'm fed enough to do this.
Hello, cutie pie.
Yeah, I don't even need to use my ult. Because it's too big of a lead right now. Like, the fact that I froze, that's the main reason. Like, even if I wasn't to get 3 kills before I killed him, if I was to just freeze it and get 1 kill, that's more than enough to dive him exactly this way. Because, like, freezing is just brutal. If someone freezes on you and you can't break the freeze, you pretty much lost your lane for the next 10 to 15 minutes. You literally lost the lane. You can't do anything at all. How much AD do they have? 1? 2 AD? I'll get this one. I'll get this one this game. The reason for the CDR is it goes really well with Tryndamere's spin, and also I'll get Black Cleaver eventually, I think. So in that sense, I will get some CDR boots. I feel like I don't need to be tanky against this guy, although I'll probably build a Tabby's afterwards, maybe towards late game when I'm tower diving a lot. I'll need the extra armor to tank the towers, like that. It always feels nice to have that extra armor because you can literally. The thing about diving after your ult is, once you ult and your ult runs out, if you have full rage bar and you Q heal, you can actually survive like a fully charged tower hit if you have some armor. If you only have the base 9 armor, it won't be enough. So our team's actually inting pretty hard, we might need to start roaming. I'm going to go and see if there's a red buff up for us, and then we're going to go mid. Let's see, Annie's dead, but she is actually fed, she's 4-2. Alright, we get a free red buff. That's pretty nice. Does he want to fight as well? Okay, we take his ward. He's up there. Where's the Thresh? Thresh is mid. Okay, I'll just indicate that I'm going to kill this Thresh. If anyone wants to come, by all means. If not, I'm just going to do this. Actually, this is really risky. I'm not going to do it. Because he could hook me and, like, just CC me. He actually wasted his flay, so I could have went on him after the flay. But it's fine. Because I don't know where the other teammates are, and yeah, Annie's actually here, so... that's interesting, that was nowhere close. So let's see, what can we do right now? We can either go top and keep pushing, and ward deep, take Zac's jungle, or we could stay mid. Okay, he actually flew really far. And he's coming back, so that means Annie's here. No? He's just coming here to int. I'm not really used to this. Okay, so Annie went a loop around. And, oh, okay. He wants the farm pretty badly. I don't know about Shaco going in here, though. Because Annie's super fed. Yeah, I don't agree with that at all. Also, there's a Thresh there. That's a good thing I didn't go in. Like, that's absolute suicide and really bronze play right there. And this Zac is like... What is he doing? I don't know where Annie is, so I'm not going to stay here. Because I don't want to give this shutdown. This is 450 gold. absolutely not worth giving a shutdown like this. So we'll clear this ward. We can clearly see the Zac. We still don't know where the Annie is, so we have to be a little bit careful. Once I see the Annie, I can start aggressing on this Thresh. These are just little rules of thumb that you have to apply in low elo in order to carry as well. Like, you just need some level of awareness, you know, and just think logically. I know it gets hard, like, you need, it takes a bit of practice still. Like, once you get really comfortable with the champion, you play it a lot, then you can start working on the awareness things and, like, just thinking logically. So those are, like, the little steps you have to take to climb out of bronze. And I'm hoping that this video will be very helpful and just highlights everything. I don't know if we're going to win this one because we have most of the kills. Actually, we should be able to. It is a bronze game. I'm thinking like in a diamond game situation, I don't know if I could win this for sure. But in a bronze game, it should be fine. We'll take some CS, but we'll also take this tower, so we're not completely dead weight. Oh, this Annie's so fed though. I'm actually really... No, this is a bad idea. This Annie's super fed. If she's not fed, I wouldn't mind doing this, like sieging the tower with three of us versus two. But also there's a Zac around here, so absolutely no way, really bad idea. We're just going to keep pushing and secure an objective. Yeah, okay, he's scared, he went the long way around, that's fine. Once we get a little bit stronger, then we can start being more Rambo. But for now, we're just going to farm up. See, we're keeping like a decent amount of CS, even though I had terrible, terrible CS at the start and I was missing a crap ton of minions. But you know, I'm still getting good CS afterwards, so that's pretty good. That's a good sign. Alright, we see Annie missing. She could be roaming top, so we're just going to back off and head towards mid. Head towards mid, see if we can catch the Annie out of position. Because this Thresh is worth nothing right now, so there's no point in diving and risking a shutdown for absolutely no gold. So that's the mistake I think a lot of low elo players make, is they decide they want to feed off of one player that's already like 0-5, 0-6, and then they actually give shutdowns at the same time, so they might be 8-1, but then they ask, why are we losing? Maybe it's because you're getting absolutely nothing out of those the last 3 or 4 kills, and you just gave 450 gold to the enemy team. So you guys have to consider that when you guys are giving shutdowns and diving like someone that's worth absolutely nothing. So that Zac just suicided, this is good. Okay, I need to go on the MF first. There we go, that's one. Let's go back to the team. That's two. We got the slow on the Zac. Okay, that's fine. So, we just solo carried that team fight, just like that. Very easily. Just pick out the priority targets and go for it. It's a lot easier for me here because it is a bronze game and everything just is toned down. Like, everything does no damage. And a lot easier to play against, so that's probably why. But in a diamond game, everyone does so much damage and I get instantly blown up. Yeah, I don't wanna... Okay, actually, that Annie ulted, I should've went in. That was a mistake on my part, like, or a mistake on her part that I didn't capitalize on, so... I'm not keen on going in. I don't wanna give the shutdown. And I can always pick up the kills later when I'm really fed, because right now I have 4,000 gold banked up and there's no point in risking it, even though I have a great score, great CS. Well, not so great CS, it's good CS. But I have a lot of gold left over, so it looks very... How do you say? It looks very deceptive. Like, it looks like I can do it, but I can't actually, like, I might be able to, but it's risky. So that, in that sense, you just want to back off and just take the safe route out, not give the shutdown. I can buy a major item and go mid and take them all out, okay? So that's what we're gonna do. So we'll get these items, we're really strong, we're quite mobile, we're going to be able to one-shot people because we have an Eye Edge, we have two Zeal items, and we have a Vamp Scepter at 20 minutes. You guys can do that just by farming like me. And actually, you guys can farm better than me, I take that back, I farm terribly like in laning phase against the Thresh. Afterwards, because there's no competition, then all the CS is free, so that's that. That MF looks like a free kill. Oh my god. Okay, maybe not, maybe not. That Anivia wall is so bad though. Okay, we got one assist. If they start tanking, I can go in. I want someone to distract them. Okay. That's an interesting Thresh hook. I think they might be headed mid. I just tell them to back off because I'm not there anymore. So... Yep. This is looking quite carryable. It's very carryable because they're all mid right now, and we can take a free tower. So now we take. Okay. How bad is the Annie? 6-4. I wasn't paying attention. I'm pretty sure she used her Tibbers though, but I'm not gonna risk the shutdown anyways. Okay, that's a Zac kill right there, unless he ults. He did not ult. Okay, that's good. If he ults, he can push us both like to the back or the side, and then he can just jump away. I think, does Zac ult give a movement speed boost? Because that's what it feels like every time I get pushed away and I get slowed, and then he just bounces away really fast. I'm actually not sure if he gets a move speed boost from bouncing away. There's a red buff up just for us, so we're gonna clear this wave and go straight to red. Wait, there's a free MF kill for us. We're just gonna kill the MF and go to red. Pop our potions. Okay, Anivia sacrificed herself for the greater good, I guess. There's no red buff because Wait, I have a red buff. I don't even know where I got it from. I must have killed everyone and got it. Oh yeah, I remember it was from the Zac. The Zac gave it to me. Really nice of him. He's a good guy. I guess Blitz is coming, Thresh is coming, and then there's an Annie coming. So we're just gonna chill for a little bit. Once they show up on different sides of the map, I'm gonna get this jungle camp. Or unless it's just the Thresh, then I'll just kill the Thresh and get the jungle camp. Because these guys give so much gold. So much CS. They give 10 CS, by the way. These golems give 10 CS, so if you can take them safely, always, always take them. Like, watch my CS go really high just because I take these golems, or I take Thresh's life at least. So, right now we're 8-0 and we're 17-17. It goes to show that our team is actually really struggling. Oh wow, okay. I don't want them to feed any more than this. This is actually getting a bit overboard. Nah. I don't have ninja tabbies to tank the tower, or I would actually go in. If I had ninja tabbies, that would have been a dive, but I don't feel confident. Because that Thresh has way too much CC. Way too many crowd controls. And if he can suddenly play well, then I'm screwed. So I'm not going to count on him playing bad. I'm just going to assume that he's going to play like what a normal Thresh would play like. Because it's very easy for him to pull off like these kind of things as a Thresh player. Is he? So he knows I'm there. He's pretty screwed. Yeah, he has to flash there, that's fine. I could flash after him and just get a kill, but I don't think it's worth it. Because is he worth anything? Did he get a kill? Actually, he did. His gold reset, never mind. There's actually like probably 5 people there. From what I can tell, I see 3. But I'm just going to back off. And because I have 3,000 gold, I might as well buy something. So I'm just going the build that I'm comfortable with. You guys don't have to go this build. This is just my personal preference. And I like it because it worked. And this is the build that got me to Diamond 1 on my main account. So this is the build that I am most comfortable with. Whenever I get suggested a different build or play a different build, I feel not as tanky. I feel maybe more mobile. I just don't play like in my comfort zone. So, oh, okay, they have a big team fight coming up. I might as well join them or see what it's about anyway. Hang around a little bit. Okay, that's the Zac ult. We'll just let them back off because they made an engage and then they had to blow some ults and some cooldowns for it. So, yeah, it doesn't look like we can catch them very convincingly. So we're just gonna let them go. And maybe good guy Zac has left us a red buff. There we go. So after that, what do you want to do when you take a red buff is you go over here and you wait for them to come and take the red buff. Or at least be like, hey, where's the red buff? Oh no, that Anivia could have stopped him. Guys, if you're playing Anivia, if the Zac starts charging up E, you put the wall on top of him and then it'll cancel his E. You guys should know to do that. I think even as bronze, you guys should know if you play Anivia a lot, which I think in the champ select, this guy said he played Anivia a lot and he plays Zed, so he should know this one. I was kind of surprised that he didn't do it. I mean, I know it's bronze, but, or silver, it's silver, so he should at least know the very basics of Anivia. Anyways, we're going to be able to probably pick up a free kill here. Absolute freebie. There we go, that's one. Can we get two? Can we? I don't have a slow, I don't want to flash W though. That's fine. Misfortune's movement speed is insane, like seriously. So fast. She has like what, 400-500 move speed? Because she's of her passive? Insane. Man, I'm just gonna do it.
Stop being such a pussy.
I didn't like the way she looked at me.
No problem.
I didn't like the way that Annie looked at me either. Yeah, I got the kill. I was just waiting for that last blob to be up. Like, I was waiting for the other two blobs to die, and then I just hit the last blob. That's like KS Master right here. No! That's my kill. Oh, whatever. Yeah, so my team's happy again. Carry us, Trin. Alright, will do, will do. I do my best. So guys, if you want to carry in bronze, just remember to play calculated and safe early game. Only punish them for their mistakes. Otherwise, don't go really ham. Don't go like really aggressive, because that only works sometimes. It's not guaranteed. Your games will be super inconsistent because you might go stupidly aggressive and you might win games off of that. But it's very unreliable, okay? And you might end up just feeding as well. So don't do that, guys. Because the only way you could lose is really just to go stupidly aggressive at the start, feed, go really far behind, and then you don't know what you're doing, and you'll probably not be in the right mentality after you feed as well. So you don't want to do that. We're probably going to be able to get full build because it is the 30 minute mark, and that's pretty standard for a full build, is around the 30 minute mark. So we're going to round this build off with a black cleaver. I'm like 400 gold off of full build, and it's not quite 30 minutes yet, so if I record 1 minute later, I would have enough gold for a full build actually. And that's what you guys should all aim for. At 30 minute mark, you should have the full build if you had a good game. I'm saying like, maybe 30 to 35 minutes, because I'm actually really fed with kills. But if you didn't have the kills, at the 35 minute mark, you should have a full build. If you had a decent game and you weren't like completely shut down, like, you know, you didn't have really bad CS and all of that jazz, you should have full build. Okay, we see an Annie where... How strong is Annie now, actually? She's 11 and 5? Jeez, she's really fed, actually. So, I'm going to assume that she can almost one-shot me, but not quite, because I am level 17. What the? He didn't turn around? My W didn't work because he didn't turn around. I just ult anyway. I actually didn't need to ult at that exact second, but it was fine. They're question mark pinging because I didn't get the redemption, but it doesn't even matter because I can self-heal. And then I'm going to start pushing top because we pretty much shut down two members. So they're going to pressure bot, we're going to pressure top. We're going to, you know, keep the pressure up on all sides of the map. And that's what split pushing is all about. It's about joining a team fight, using your cooldowns, maybe getting picked off. That's the most optimal situation anyway. And also rotating. So you could do that like... You could either split push first and then rotate, get a team fight going. Well, not necessarily get it going, but contribute to it. Blow all your cooldowns, you know, do as much as you possibly can for the team fight, and then rotate to split push, and then like just keeps going. But that's always situational as well. It depends on how they respond to your split push as well. So there's a lot of situations actually, and I think I highlighted a little better in my Nautilus games from my previous videos, so you guys should watch that one if you want to know more about like split pushing and rotating. And those are diamond games, so you guys can... okay. I can't kill the Zac, and he's gonna peel for the MF, so there's no point, and also I had no ult, so I'm definitely not going to just die for free there. The worst thing you can do in a split push is die for free. And this is a free tower because there's only a Zac here, nothing else. Oh, that was my kill. Oh well. That's fine. I'm going to go home and complete my build. I don't want it to end just yet. I want to go get Inferno Drake, get Baron, get a few more kills, you know, for that dank, fresh, like, good-looking thumbnail, so I can say, hey, I got 20 kills. Because the only way you can get that many kills is if the game lasts long enough. Otherwise, it's not possible to get that many kills. Also, I clicked on the wrong potion. You should always get the Elixir of Iron, because you don't have Merc Treads. If you have Merc Treads, don't get it. The reason being is you want the 25 tenacity. So if you guys don't know, Elixir of Iron gives 25% tenacity. What does Merc Treads give, like 35%? It's still really close, so 30%. So it's pretty much a Merc Treads that you don't have to buy. If you get the Elixir of Iron, always get that for Tryndamere, because, well, actually, not necessarily, only if they have a lot of CC on their team, then you get the Elixir of Iron. So we're at 353 CS on 32 minutes. That's actually really good, because we're able to just freely roam around the entire map. We also forced an ult, so we're just gonna back off. I don't know why Shaco's here, it will absolutely achieve nothing by it being with us, though. The thing about split push is it's completely ruined if people group with you, even one person grouping with you, like the split push is ruined. So I'm gonna go bot and try to get something going. The only reason why I was up here was because I saw someone over here after I got red. So let's push this in. And also, don't worry about the Smurf games. I'm going to have, you know, diamond games soon. I just have the Smurf games maybe once a week. It's just so that I could relax, and also because, you know, majority, like 70-80% of the players out there are in silver and are in bronze. So this will completely apply to you guys. Not all of you, just some of you. Ouch. Okay, I have to ult. I just got blitzhooked. Alright, I have to get out. I have to get out or I'll be dead. That was pretty sloppy of me. I got blitzhooked. Actually, it was really messy. I was probably just focused on talking, so I need to pay attention more to that. I'll heal up and then I'll join the team fight again. If it's still going and it's favorable. Can we do this?
Surprise!
Okay, that, that just looked funny. that looked really funny. End. There's a Zac there. We might be able to end. I don't really want to end though. I want to get more kills. It's just more fun. There was actually a slight doubt in my mind that we're gonna lose, but then I remember it was a bronze game, so it was actually okay. But otherwise, there was never a doubt. If you disregard that, there was never a doubt in my mind that we're gonna lose, guys. Oh no, I'm gonna die. Okay, no, I'm not gonna die. I thought that Annie was gonna one-shot me. Can I get more kills? I want more kills. Or at least I want the plus 50. Alright, that is game, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the Smurf game. I don't know if I don't know if I should make more of these. Just let me know if I should make these once a week, and I'll see to it, okay? So thank you so much for watching to the very end, guys. I'll be back with a video tomorrow, so stay tuned. Please do hit the like and the subscribe. It does help my channel grow. And if you guys want my channel to grow and you guys enjoy my content, that would help me so much. So thank you for watching. I'll see you all next time. Cheers.